Hello everyone, welcome by New Language Serie video. And today I'm going to talk about the Arabic language, because I spoke about a lot of languages, but one big language, Arabic, wasn't part of the... we didn't do Arabic yet. So the Arabic language, information. Arabic is part of the Afro-Asiatic family language group, and it's one of the most widely spoken. It is mainly spoken in North Africa and a lot of Asian countries. It is also spoken in a very small part of Europe, mainly in southern Spain and southern Portugal. However, knowing the Arabic language doesn't mean you can make you understandable in every Arabic-speaking country. Since there are many dialects, in the image below you can see how many there are. Continuing on, alphabet. Your officially Arabic uses the Arabic alphabet, but Lebanon uses the Romanian alphabet, while in Egypt sometimes hieroglyphs are still used. Also, when you use the Arabic alphabet writing system, keep in mind that you need to write from right to left, rather than the other way around like you're used to in English. Literary Arabic. In the main Arabic language, you can see that there are different forms of past time, but let's use the Romanian alphabet in these examples to not make it too difficult. So we can see here, katuptu, katuptu, of something like that, means I wrote, while kataptu, of kataptu, means I had written. So you can see, basically, it means the same, but if you want to get an A on your in your Arabic class, you have to literally write it like this. So we can see that the difference is minor, but in a lot of past tenses, the sound of key, T, and B are used. Now let's take a look at some sentence examples. So in Arabic, you read it like this, and you say, Lina Rai, which means it is great. So we can see that it says it is great, nothing too special here. Another sentence then, Arabic. Awesome Harwit Alawim, which means in English, the sun is hot today. But we can see if we take a closer look to Arabic language again, that there is no word for, or that there is no translation for the word term. The is missing in Arabic sentence language. And also is the word is. Because if we see the Arabic language, then little bit the standing is there, sun hot today. Rather than in English, the sun is hot today. So with that, we now know that some words like the and is do not exist in Arabic. Another sentence then. Ashwab alcohol, which in English means I drink alcohol. And now we can also see that the word alcohol from English does indeed come from the word alcohol. Well, to be completely clear on it, alcohol actually transported in Spain first. There you say alcohol, which later became alcohol in English. So we see that there are some, which means that there are some loanwords from Arabic in English, but not too many. Alcohol is probably one of the most known ones. However, let's talk a little bit more about the influence in Spanish. Historically, almost the complete mainland of Spain is spoken Arabic, but has disappeared in almost the whole country. But some influences still exist, like the U sounds, like you say IO and something like that. And the word Eros means wise in both languages. So how old is the Arabic language? Now, we now know that the country of Lebanon uses the Romanian alphabet, which does not mean that Arabic is still a hard language to figure out, of course, but now we know that there is actually one country which uses the Roman alphabet. It might be a little bit better to focus on one thing at first, so not learning the alphabet, the writing system and the language at once, but do it step by step. So first learn the spoken language, and after that learn the alphabet, and after that learn the writing system. That might be one way of doing it a little bit easier. Of course, the Arabic language is still a difficult language, but yeah, of course I do recommend to learn these three things step by step. Of course it's going to take some time, it will not go so fast as learning Spanish, because Spanish has the same alphabet, has a lot of words which are the same in English. But yeah, of course in Arabic this is not really the case. So yeah, it might take take a full year before you really call a hand on the Arabic language. But yeah, it is better to take a step than wash it through, because usually on washing it through you will learn something, but not really how the language is supposed to be. So yeah, that is what I do recommend. Of course, Arabic is in the fourth language group, so it is still a little bit easier as Japanese and Chinese, which are all in the hardest language group, but yeah, but still, it might take a while to learn Arabic, and of course what is more, that you also don't know the other dialects then, so really the best way to learn Arabic is indeed to do step by step, but also to travel to these countries where Arabic is spoken, because it has so many dialects that it is not really 100% completely learnable by only taking classes. So yeah, this has been this video for today then. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I see you guys next time.